Hey, more some Time Lords and Time Touch Travelers, it's Garrus17Mini14 here, and welcome to another tutorial video of how to put a capture card, well, use a capture card for the original Xbox and maybe some of our retro consoles, but anyways, this one's for the Xbox anyways. So, you guys probably want to do some live streams or record some games that you grew up with, childhood and all that nostalgia and everything, and you realize, some capture cards are not working. Well, this one capture card actually works, and this video, by the way, I got from someone named the video I got from the person named Koshmo. Shout out to that guy, his method is brilliant, so I thought, why not, because their tutorial video is from 2021, so let's have a video for, well, 2023 all the way up to the future. So I'm gonna show you what you guys are gonna need, and I'm just gonna close that. Okay, that's out the way now, bye bye. Okay, so what you're gonna need, guys, that's gonna be in the description below for the UK version of Amazon and the US version, so yeah. And don't worry, there's nothing going to be on the screen. I'm just doing this so you know. Just near. Anyways, okay. So there are two things you're going to need. You're going to need this, which is known as a... If the webcam can focus, there you go. You're going to need a video capture with loop, which is basically in the description below. And you're going to need one of these. It is a mini AV2 HDMI upscaler to 1080p. So, what you want to do is, you want to turn on your Xbox original. Make sure that before you do, make sure this is connected into your TV. Even if you have a HDMI TV, make sure you have the your date, your time, and all that set up. So, make sure you do that, and then when you've done that, make sure that you unplug the AVI cable out of your TV for a minute, leave the Xbox running for a bit, because this is going to be really good for the tutorial. So basically, you want to take this, which is basically your mini AV2 to HDMI, make sure you can upscale it to 720p or 1080p. I would suggest 1080p because it's good. So you want to make sure which colors you've got. So you've got red, white, and blue. So you want to make sure you got red. So here's red, white. So white goes in, yellow, because that's your sound, because one is the picture, one is the sound, and what the heck just fell off? Oh, the capture loop fell off. That scared me, and my bottle's down here full of water, so I can have a water break in case if I need it. But anyways, that scared me a little bit. So anyways, that's now connected. So once that's connected, you want to make sure you have your cable for it, so making sure that it is connected. So hopefully you just plug that in. The cable's now plugged in. And then you want to connect it into, if you've got a power bar, like a power plug or whatever they call it, power cable thing, you can, if it's got a USB thing, then yes. But if you've got a USB plug, just get a USB plug, plug it onto here, and then just plug it in. Or you can plug it into your USB slot. Or if you don't have one of those, if your TV has a USB on the side, plug it into your TV. But yeah, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna plug this into my actual it's gonna be plugged into the actual USB plug, because I have one. So when that is connected, the next thing you want to do is grab your HDMI cable. You're gonna need two of them, and you want to connect it up to here, so output, yes. And then also when this is plugged in, so I'm gonna plug this in right now, so technically plugging it in. Okay, it's plugged in now. So once that's plugged in, you wanna take your USB, by the way. And no, not USB, tongue twist. Anyways, you want to take your capture card right now. So first, we're gonna do the first thing that's important. So the capture card will come with two cables. One's like a USB to plug it in, so you will need a plug for that. or you could just plug it into the computer, but I would recommend getting a USB plug to plug it into. But anyways, make sure you have this as well. This is your cable, by the way. Make sure that goes into here, making sure that shown on camera. But yeah, that's got to go in. So that's for your computer, which that will show up after. Okay, so then when that's like connected in, but yeah, anyways, when that's connected up, don't plug this in yet. You want to connect your AVI to HDMI to your capture card. Now the question is, because Koshmo did the same thing, yeah, it did question me for some reason, but you're probably asking, but Gear 17, doesn't the output have to go to the TV or something? No, basically you've already got the output. Well, I'm trying to explain this right now. Well, let me just unplug that for a minute. Basically what's happening is the output is going all the way up and it's going into input. So the sound is going to be traveling up here into the cable and up into the to the actual HDMI, well, the actual capture card itself. So I'm going to make sure that stays plugged in. And yeah, that's plugged in. Lovely. Okay. So when this is plugged in, you'll get a lovely red light. Which is basically showing right there, as you can see, that's on. While that's on, you want to take your cable that's got your plug, and you want to plug that in for the capture card. So, yep, that's what you need to do. So I'm just plugging this in right now and connecting it up to the wire. So, yep. If I can get it into the wire, wrong way. There you go. So now that's connected in. There's also a light for that on. Now, the next thing you want to do is you want to get another HDMI cable that goes to the TV. Mine's already in the TV, so you want to make sure to connect that. So that's going to go to output. And I do apologize for the background noise, if you can hear it or not. That's my sibling going downstairs, I think. I don't know. But anyways, once that's connected up, the next step is you want to make sure your Xbox original is plugged in. I just got to make sure mine is plugged in as well. Yep, it's plugged in. Because I've got another stand over there, basically. I got one of the plug stands there. That's got it plugged in with the TV. So, yeah. The next thing you want to do now is we're going to connect this up to the computer. It's going to make a noise. It's going to go doo-doo-doo. That means it connects and all that stuff. And yeah, so let's head over to the OBS and then we'll do the next step. So yeah, let's head over there right now. Okay, so here we are. We're on the computer right now. So anyways, the next thing you want to do is you want to come down to here, click the plus, and you want to look for the video capture device. Now you want to name this whatever you want it to be, but I would recommend calling it Video Capture Loop. But sometimes I would call it this, Capture Card. There we go. And then you've got the next thing that pops up is this. So technically, as you can see here, you want to click on this device, go to USB video. There it is. There's the actual capture card itself. It's showing up right now. I can shrink that down a bit. Hold on. Poof. So here it is. There's the capture device showing up here. I'll just put that there. And this can be seen right here. Shrink it down a little bit. So when that shows up, I'm just going to put my TV on right now. Make sure that your sound is working for this. Because once the actual device shows up, then yeah. So here's all the device stuff, by the way. There's a resolution, max out FPS, and all that stuff. You can do custom stuff for it, but yeah, you can do custom stuff, which actually just does this, really. And you can get the resolution for it, so 1080p, and then, you know. But I would leave it at its default, so there we go. And there's also a... Oh, there we go. Yeah, there's also a thing right here the properties, which you probably can't see that. There's properties here, but I recommend leave the properties alone. Don't mess with anything, and then just click OK. And also, I'm going to lock it so it stays there for a minute. Also, if I want to scale it, by the way, I'm going to scale the filtering Lancos because it's really good. And then, now the next step is turn on the Xbox, which should make a noise. So it's making its noise right now. And here it is. There's the Xbox. This is real, and it's making the noise and all that stuff. It's very loud. And then the audio should come through. There you go, it's loaded. It's coming through perfectly. And it's very, probably not that loud, I guess, because of the actual thing. So yeah, it's actually really good. So I'm just gonna bring that to full screen right now. Let's bring it up. Let's see if I can full screen it. Probably not, but there are ways you can actually make the actual thing wider, I think. If it doesn't actually take up all the screen, oh wait, it has, there we go, lovely. There you go. And you can actually set up everything. So right now I'm gonna go into settings. There's the clock, video. I'm just gonna head to video. Here we go, it's got my actual stuff, PAL and everything, which is good. My TV does support it, I think, yes. Widescreen, letterbox, normal. Let's do this. I'm gonna do this real quick. Ah, lovely. Because I heard in letterboxes, they make the cutscenes more better. But if you want to make it more widescreen, then yeah. I guess this is like for different TVs. Here's the classic. Here's a classic TV. Just gonna go normal. Nothing happened. Letterbox, yeah. And also, I like to thank Koshmo for this tutorial. It's actually pretty good. I actually am happy with it. I did leave a comment saying he is a legend or something. I can't remember, but yeah. I want to widescreen? I don't know. I can't decide. But yeah. I am so happy with this. It's pretty good. But yeah, whatever you see on the capture card is fine, but on my TV is a little bit poof. So yeah, I'm actually going to leave it widescreen. Why not? Yeah, as you can see, whenever you change your settings, it does that. And you can see there's a sign up there that says AV to PAL, which is good. And it disappears, don't worry. It's fine. Audio, there it is. Everything. So yeah. Every time when you mess around with the settings, yeah, the thing will say AVI to HDMI, or it will say PAL or anything, because it depends which console you have, but yeah. I'm just going to turn on my webcam so you can see me now. Okay, so now the webcam is there. This is it. This is brilliant. I can play any game I want. Do I have a game that I can pull out real quick? Let me see if I've got a game, guys. Quick game. Let me see. Spider-Man. We're gonna pull out this game. Okay, let's pull out the game. Get out the way, phone. Okay. Gonna put the disc in and close it in, and it's also going to probably do a thing where it's going to flicker. Now I don't know how the audio will be for this. Hopefully you can still hear me. I will go back and check on here. I'm just gonna unravel my controller. Oh, no signal. Up, there we go. And it says right there, well, I'm pointing right there in the top thing, it says AV to PAL 60. Now, yeah, that's how it's going to be, because don't forget the capture card is reading everything as well. And oh my god, I can't believe I'm playing with a capture card. So yeah, all right, can we skip this? Thank you. Ooh, nice. Let's play. Start. Hopefully I can remember how to play. And also, I need to sort out my, ooh, flippin' egg. I need to sort out my, alright, I'll sort that out later. My TV needs sorting out. Training or new game? We'll go new game. Classic, left thumbstick, normal. We're gonna play. We're gonna play
this
a couple games.
This is how my story begins.
Yeah, skip. We're just gonna skip to the cutscene. I could actually sort my TV out right now. The pitch is a little bit, yes. I have a game mode.
Uncle Ben. Murdered.
There you go, standard.
I have to find the guy.
It'll have
who
to
did.
Do. Yeah. It will have to do. So yeah, I can change the picture of it.
Nothing Peter Parker can do at this point.
But
Spider-Man is a different story.
So I'm able to play the game, I guess. I can tell on the TV it's a little bit.
This is supposed to be the Skulls' territory.
Yeah.
I'll find Uncle Ben's killer if I have to go through every one of the Skulls to do it.
Yeah, I don't know. Is that supposed to be like that? I don't know. I could have a look. Maybe it's because of the video and everything. But yeah. I'll just shrink that down a little bit so we can see that. But at least the game looks good. Let's go. At least you're not seeing what's on my TV. The color's a little bit washed out on the TV.
Out of my way.
But, yeah.
Here's a tip for when you're on the side of a building.
Here's a tip when you're on the side of the building. No. I don't want to be on the building. Alright, there's the other guy.
Who's that?
I'm gonna
now, I don't know if this will
anything.
Work for, my other... I've got a HDMI thing for the original Xbox, I think, somewhere. Like a HDMI. It's like it's this really popular thing. It's like a little box thing, but I'm not sure. I'm not so sure where that is, people. So yeah, the game play seems to be very useful. Now, yeah.
Circus in town?
Boom. Hello. Come here. Dead. Nice. Oh, hello.
What's with the getup, chump?
Whee! I got him. See you later.
Well, one of these
I'll play for a few more minutes and then hopefully I can wrap it up here, people. And then hopefully, yeah, that'll be it. For today. I'm gonna play the lovely secret level for Spider-Man.
Thank you so much. You saved my life.
Don't worry about it, lady.
I'm
happy. Gotta go.
Wait.
It's really good. It's actually amazing.
I lost my purse on one of the rooftops around here.
On a different rooftop?
Well,
yes.
Different from
Koshiro
this one?
Says,
yes.
Are you serious?
You have to do a thing to
are
get it to
work a little bit. Are you taking
some
kind of tour of city rooftops?
More, by the way.
Yes.
I just noticed,
okay. Whatever. I'll find your
noticed,
purse
like,
for you.
Thank you.
There we go. Oh, that was loud. I'm more louder than you. Oh. Game, I'm louder than you, probably. If not, I can do a trick. I'll just turn down the audio. So just flick, 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 flick. There we go. A little bit down. There we go. Don't want it to be too loud. Okay, better. Woo! So yeah, hopefully I'm gonna probably also do a tutorial on how to make your OBS recording sound amazing as well.
Can't get away from me.
Right now. Things are looking good, and... this is amazing.
Here's your purse back.
Thank you so much.
I'm happy. Like,
this city
I want to cry right now.
Masked vigilantes
with happy tears,
like you.
But yeah.
If you say so.
Yeah.
Try to stay off rooftops from now on.
A lot of gang members seem to hang up a lot here.
I will. Oof. Thanks again.
Yep. Nice. And now we can jump off the building like a lunatic. Whee! And... nah. I'm gonna do it. Whee! Spider-Man's... in the newspaper now. There's a tiny dot. You can't see me. Little tiny dot. Okay. Yeah. It's pretty amazing, by the way. Also, I just noticed it's a little bit blurry on the thing. I wonder why. I think it's got to be the 60 PAL thing. I'm going to go back and check. It could be that. Because see, the thing says AV PAL right now. So, yeah. Okay, I'm going to go back and then probably end the actual stuff here. We're going to put to no. So, I guess that will kind of fix the game a little bit. I don't know. Now we'll go back into the game and have a look, probably. Okay, let's have a look. Did I fix stuff? Because if not, oh well, I can still probably get things sorted. But not to worry, I do have the HDMI other thing somewhere. Oh, I think that fixed it. I don't know. Let's have a look. Let's have a look. Let's skip. 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 Okay, let's have a look. I think it did. We'll try the tutorial this time. See, have a look. I don't know. It's probably... I think it did work. I don't know. We'll try the tutorial. Left thumbstick. If you have the chance. It seems like it's working. I think I'm not supposed to put 60 on there.
Greetings.
Welcome to the tutorial. Yeah, I know. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I think it worked. I think the pitch is fine.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Careful there, Captain Jumpy.
Yeah?
Now, since you're just getting started, we're going to let you get away with... Well, good to see that you can follow basic...
Yeah, I can follow basic instructions. Now, oh, I fell down. Oops, okay. All right, let's get down here and then skip some of the stuff.
Uh-huh, you just couldn't...
Yep, skip, double jump. Can't swing, darn. Let's go.
Now, this doohickey is the hype meter, not...
Shut up. Don't care. Up!
This is incredible! Am I really
doing
this?
Found out I can crouch, by the way, by holding down the crouch button.
You haven't even gotten to the good stuff yet.
So basically, this is like a stealth thing. I can be stealthy on the floor. Spider-Man stealthy on the floor.
Ooh, that's some view, huh?
Yes, it's a great view. Now, we're just going to go this way, go here.
Okay, the topic at hand...
Yahoo!
Hey, king of the world. Don't let it go to your head, okay? Hooray for you, you're swinging. But sooner or later, you're probably going to want to drop. You can break your web line by pressing the A button.
Ah, that's classic. Okay, so, yeah. What do I rate this to the tutorial from Koshmo, by the way, viewers? I guess I can rate it a, I guess I'll give it more of a 10 out of 10. It's good. The picture, when I zoom in for it, if I zoom it in for you guys right now, if I bring it all the way, it kind of looks a little bit, It kind of looks okay. See, if we move my webcam out the way, then there you go. Good picture of that. Yeah, so I'm going to rate it 10 out of 10, but I know the picture doesn't look... much good to well, actually the picture looks all right, I guess, even though if it's on an old console, because I did do a Elgato tutorial, well, not a tutorial actually, sorry, an Elgato gameplay video, and the picture is the same as this, but yeah, but I gotta say it's actually worth it, because a lot of people do stream a lot of games on the actual console that's retro and everything and all that stuff, and trust me, I've seen speedruns, including replays on YouTube, so the picture does look like this, what you're seeing on there. But anyways, that's it for the tutorial. I hope you like the gameplay as well. Make sure to subscribe, like, comment for more, follow me on my social media like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, join my Discord server. Check out the video from Koshmo. Thanks to them for this tutorial. It's really good. I'm going to say 10 out of 10 for the capture card. The picture quality, 10 out of 10. Yeah, it's not that bad. I guess it's pretty good. And a lot of people would want to stream games like this. I would. Trust me, I would. And yeah, that's it for the tutorial. So if you have any questions, by the way, you can ask me or go over to Koshmo, go to his video and leave many comments to him as well to ask him stuff. He'll probably try and answer as he can to you guys. But yeah, anyways, see you guys probably next time in another video of wherever it's going to be, more Let's Play or a another tutorial video. So yeah. Bye, guys.